Hello and welcome to Verdict 2015, our special broadcast on all news and updates on Bihar polls, where we also get you news analysis from our team of experts. I'm Aishwarya Kapoor. Let us begin with the election headlines. Prime Minister to address two rallies in Bihar today. On a Thursday, PM Modi had broken his silence on the Dadri lynching, calling for tolerance. Election Commission to look into PM's speech in Munger to find out if anything said violated the model code of conduct. BSP to officially launch its Bihar campaign. Chief Mayawati to address two rallies in Banka and Aurangabad. And today we throw the spotlight on Jamui, where one of the key electoral battles in the state will be fought with the NDA's unity in tatters. Well, our top focus from the Bihar campaign trail. After a jam-packed schedule yesterday where he addressed four rallies, Prime Minister Narendra Modi will address two rallies today. Now, he would today address rallies in Sasaram and Aurangabad. Polling in the two districts will take place in the second phase. The second phase of polling will be conducted on 16th of October. Now, 32 constituencies and 6 districts are going to polls in phase 2. 456 candidates are in the fray, including 32 women. And facing criticism over his silence on the Dadri lynching incident, Prime Minister Narendra Modi finally spoke out against intolerance. Addressing a rally in Bihar, the Prime Minister endorsed the words of the President and called for peace between all communities. Now, his reaction came in the last of the four rallies that he addressed on Thursday.
Prime Minister Narendra Modi broke his silence on communal violence in the country. While addressing a rally in Nevada, Modi endorsed the words of President Pranab Mukherjee and called for tolerance and plurality. He said the time has come to stand together as one and put an end to communal forces.
Kya Hinduon ne Musalman ke khilaf ladna hai ki garibi ke khilaf ladna hai? Musalman tay kar le ki Hindu ke khilaf ladna hai. कि गरीबी के खिलाफ लड़ना है अगर सुनना है तो कल हमारे देश के राष्ट्रपति श्रद्धेय प्रणब मुखर्जी दादा ने जो भाषण किया है और देश को जो संदेश दिया है उससे बड़ा कोई मार्गदर्शन नहीं हो सकता है.
Earlier in the day, while addressing a rally in Munger, the Prime Minister waded into the beef controversy. Narendra Modi attacked RJD Supremo Lalu Prasad over his "Hindus also eat beef" remark. The Prime Minister said that Lalu has insulted people of Bihar and particularly his community who had brought him to power.
आज यदुओं से लोग अगर आपको कोई सवाल करते हो तो आप उन पर क्या-क्या आरोप लगाते हो? जो गंभीर आरोप उन्होंने लगाए हैं कि यदुवंशी क्या खाते हैं, ये यदुवंश का अपमान है कि नहीं भाइयों?
The Prime Minister tried to make a connection with the youth and appeal to them to throw the present government out of power for the development of the state.
क्या बिहार को और अधिक बर्बाद होने देना है? बिहार की तबाही से बिहार को मुक्त कराना है? तो 60 साल तक जिन्होंने बिहार के भविष्य को रौंद डाला है, क्या ऐसे महास्वार्थ बंधन को अब बिहार में जगह देनी चाहिए?
The Prime Minister also took the opportunity to slam the Congress party, saying it had lost its force and potential in the state.
और एक कांग्रेस पार्टी भी जब सामने से उसकी आने की ताकत खत्म हो गई है तो पिछले दरवाजे से आते हैं.
The Prime Minister is likely to make a night halt in Patna today and meet BJP's Bihar associated poll managers and core group to review the electoral strategy and assess the situation. Bureau report, Rajya Sabha Television.
Meanwhile, the Election Commission will review Prime Minister Narendra Modi's speeches on Thursday to see if anything has been said which violates the model code of conduct. Now, the Model Code of Conduct Committee under the Munger District Magistrate would look into the Prime Minister's speech. Now, addressing an election rally at Munger, the Prime Minister had said that RJD Chief Lalu Prasad cannot absolve himself of his controversial beef remarks by claiming that it was the shaitan on his tongue which made him say it. The PM also blamed RJD Chief for insulting Yadavs by his utterances. The PM made a similar reference in his speeches at Begusarai and Samastipur as well. All right, let's get a perspective on that story. Mr. Krishna Kumar Singh, who's a senior journalist now, is now joining us. Good morning, Mr. Singh, and thank you so much for joining us this morning. Mr. Singh, now at his election rallies, the PM Modi yesterday turned to the two Ys, youth and the Yadavs, to vote the BJP-led NDA to power. So how important are these two segments?
About this Yadav and this... Yesterday's Modi's speech, I strongly feel it has rather aggravated the communal agenda of NDA. And I should not be, I should be very much clear that this time this Prime Minister has, Mr. Narendra Modi has referred about this Dadri and this communal, this beef controversy and lambasted Lalu Prasad Yadav for Hindu also eating beef. It has rather aggravated the situation.
Okay.
And I think he should not have uttered all these things which raises communal passion. It is up to the election commission to decide. But Mr. Modi should not have spoken such thing about anything about this communalism, about this Hindu religion during elections.
But and it is also the other parties. Mr. Singh, also the other parties, in fact, JDU and in fact, Lalu Prasad himself has, commented on Mohan Bhagwat's remark as well. And now this reaction coming in after Lalu Prasad had himself spoken that Hindus don't eat meat. So it is not just one party that we can really blame, isn't it?
It is not about this Mohan Bhagwat. He spoke about the principle. The reservation should be, should stay or not. For this, a committee should be set up. Mohan Bhagwat has stressed the need of a review of this reservation. And then rightly, this party, opposition parties like Lalu commented on that, and it is applied to deprive reservation from backwards and Dalit. But about this beef, about repeated persistence, Lalu spoke about, Hindu bhi beef khate hain. So this should not also, Lalu should not have spoken such thing. But the strategy of being a prime minister, he should not have spoken about this. And that also in caste angle, oh, Jadwansi, will you vote for this man who is advocating beef eating for Hindu? And this is the first time I have seen, right from 1960 during my college days, for the first time, a prime minister has stayed overnight for reviewing the elections. And this Narendra Modi has stayed here in Patna last night, and today he has two or three election meetings. And he met a large number of people this associated with the Hindu Parivar in Raj Bhavan itself, and also party leaders. And made out, it is reported that many strategies have been chalked out to win the election by any way, by hook or crook. And this others also spoke, but in this election speech, I think Nitish is doing very disciplined job in expressing his opinion. But this NDA men, they are crossing all the limits, and also Mr. Lalu Prasad Yadav. Thus, I strongly feel such things should not happen. And this thing, this Bihar election, I fear, I apprehend, it will spread communal passion throughout the country.
Okay.
The Dadri has happened over there. In Bombay, Ghulam Ali was not allowed to do his concert. And there are many instances. And sometime abusing Bihar by Narendra Modi, sometime spreading communal agenda. It will be very, very, it will have very bad, worst impact throughout the country. In Bombay, in Delhi, everywhere there is a communal passion. And this,
Mr. Singh,
this statements of these, all these leaders in Bihar election will definitely mark the prospect of communal harmony in the country.
Mr. Singh, you must be following the Bihar elections all these years. Do you think that this time probably the elections have more of communal color than compared to the last elections that you've seen over the years?
It is a worst communal color. I have never seen this last assembly elections right from 60. I was in college. Thereafter, I came in the profession in 1965. In journalism, but I have never seen such communal agenda in any election, either in
why do you think this is happening
Bihar,
this time so strongly?
Or the Lok Sabha elections.
No, but why do you think it is happening so strongly this time?
These people have become disparate. Disparate. The NDA man has. Have also become disparate, and this Grand Alliance people have also become disparate. The only thing is left to anything retain power, to anything to grab power, and that is a very easy thing for this NDA and particularly BJP to make this election, to give this election a communal color. And the BJP is doing all these things. Before also, in the last assembly elections, when this Nitish and BJP were fighting together, such thing did never happen. Such communal color was never given. But this time, Narendra Modi and his company is doing extra homework to give communal color to election. Never
right.
seen
so
before
there is
in
a
the
desperation.
Of Bihar, independent Bihar.
Yeah, so there is a desperation that you're saying that is probably seen in both the parties, and more so pointing to the fact that there is going to be a neck and neck fight between the two grand between the two alliances in the state. Mr. Singh, you stay with us. We'll just come back to you. Meanwhile, the Bahujan Samaj Party will kick off its Bihar campaign, which is the 9th death anniversary of the party's founder, Kanchi Ram. Now, party president and former Uttar Pradesh Chief Minister Mayawati will address her first rally in Banka and a second one in Aurangabad, where today the Prime Minister will also be addressing a rally. Mayawati is expected to address 12 rallies over a span of 6 days. The BSP is contesting in all the 243 seats in the Bihar Assembly. The party has been faced with repeated electoral defeats in the past and is looking to drum up support, and has also asked the party workers to host a series of meetings in all zones in the states. Now, a host of senior leaders have been asked to camp in the state. Remember, the party drew a blank in the 2010 Bihar Assembly polls. In 2005, it had won two seats after fielding candidates in 238 constituencies, and it bagged five of the 249 seats that it had contested in the year 2000, when undivided Bihar had 324 assembly seats. All right, let's go back to Mr. Krishna Kumar Singh, who's a senior journalist. Mr. Singh, now, We're looking at both the camps, with the Mahagathbandhan as well as the NDA camp. But other key campaigners, it seems, are yet to take stage because BSP is launching its campaign. But SP Chief Mulayam Singh Yadav has stayed away from canvassing. Also, NCP President Sharad Pawar is nowhere to be seen. So what do you think is the reason for this?
I feel these alliances are इनसिग्निफिकेंट स्टेक होल्डर्स इन दिस कंटेस्ट कीनली कंटेस्टेड इलेक्शन बिटवीन दिस ग्रैंड अलायंस एंड एनडीए एज दिस मायावती यूज टू डू बेटर in previous elections in previous before that last election also but this time this Mayawati's rampant money politics collecting money she has become utterly unpopular among even Dalits also about this Sarad Pawar is nowhere he has not come his representative Mr. Tariq Anwar is and the NCP is with Samajwadi Party. Samajwadi Party and others few parties are contesting this election together. But they are of nowhere. And in this Simanchal area where Muslim populations are dominated, the Simanchal, entire Simanchal is dominated by Muslim population. Where this OBC Sahab has declared that he will contest all the 24 or 26 seats. I do not remember. But later
on... No, AIMM is contesting on six seats. Mr. Singh?
Only six seats.
Yes.
Now, on the pressure of this local people, he is now only contesting six seats. And that also, they have become very silent now. Silent in the sense that they are not going to create many problems for this grand alliance.
No, but Mr. Singh, what is AIMM's game plan? Because even if it wins all the six seats that it is contesting, what do you think it is going to achieve?
Achieve only its presence in Bihar.
No, but so it'll be called a vote cutter. Then it'll be called a vote cutter. Then
vote cutter. They will definitely cut some votes of Muslims, but no significant impact will be there because all these controversies and this communal color being given by NDA to this Bihar upcoming elections, the Muslims appear to be united behind this grand alliance, I think.
All right, Mr. Singh, thank you so much for joining us this morning and sharing your perspective on Bihar polls. The first phase is going to start in a few days from now. We'll keep coming back to you, Mr. Singh, for more perspective in the subsequent bulletins. Meanwhile, leaders of the Grand Alliance, RJD Chief Lalu Prasad Yadav and Chief Minister Nitish Kumar addressed election rallies in Jammu and Aurangabad on Thursday. Both the leaders took on BJP's star campaigner, Prime Minister Narendra Modi. RJD President Lalu Prasad Yadav lashed out at the BJP and its star campaigner Narendra Modi during his rally in Jammu in Bihar. The caste factor was back in focus as Lalu responded to Modi's Jungle Raj barb, saying that it was instead time for Mandal Raj Part 2 in the state. Lalu also slammed BJP's poll promises, saying the promise of free TVs and laptops would not be able to sway the youth voters towards the BJP. Meanwhile, Chief Minister Nitish Kumar held two rallies in Aurangabad. Launching a direct attack on the Prime Minister, Nitish said that the BJP did not have any leader of significance who could campaign in Bihar.
Bihar mein koi neta to hai nahi. कि जिसका चेहरा सामने रखे तो प्रधानमंत्री जी को ही उतार दिया।
He also defended his rule in Bihar, saying that figures proved that the situation was worse in states ruled by the BJP. Bureau report, Rajya Sabha TV. And in Verdict 2015, we'll take a very short break. We'll be back with more election news. Stay with us. Welcome back. Now, the BJP is pitching for development in Bihar. While caste is seen as a crucial factor, the party is trying to project its chief campaigner, Prime Minister Modi, as synonymous to development. Our correspondent Neelu Vyas spoke to Bihar BJP leader Nand Kishore Yadav to find out more about the party's campaign strategy.
जब तक हम इस सरकार में शामिल थे और जो विभाग भाजपा के मंत्रियों के पास थे, उन विभागों ने बेहतर काम करके दिखाया है। आप बिहार के विकास की जब चर्चा करते हैं तो आप बिहार के सड़कों के बारे में चर्चा करते हैं। सड़क विभाग का मंत्री भाजपा का था, मैं खुद था। आप बेहतर स्वास्थ्य की चर्चा करते हैं, स्वास्थ्य विभाग का मंत्री केवल भाजपा का था। तो भाजपा के मंत्री जिस विभाग का जिम्मेवारी संभाल रहे थे उसमें बेहतर काम हुए। और 2.5 साल से जब से भाजपा अलग हुई तब से हर प्रकार के काम में डिटोरेशन आ गया।
लोग यहाँ पर ये भी बोल रहे हैं कि बीजेपी को लालू यादव ने मजबूर किया है कि वो इस पूरे चुनाव में वो कास्ट की भी बात करे, बिकॉज जब से उन्होंने यदुवंशियों को कंसोलिडेट करने की बात कही है, बीजेपी हैज बीन फोर्स्ड टू ब्रिंग इन दैट काइंड ऑफ अ डिस्कोर्स वेयर टॉक्स डेवलपमेंट अलोंग विद कास्ट। क्या ये सही बात है?
नहीं, ये उल्टी बात है। सच ये है कि लालू यादव जी विकास के मुद्दे से लोगों का ध्यान बांटना चाहते हैं, इसलिए वो जाति की बात करना चाहते हैं। जब विकास की चर्चा होगी तो सवाल खड़ा होगा, लालू जी ने 15 साल में क्या किया? इस सवाल का जवाब उनके पास नहीं है, इसलिए इस मुद्दे से भटकाना चाहते हैं लोगों को। उनके भटकाने के बाद भी लोग भटकने वाले नहीं।
बीजेपी बार बार जंगल राज की बात कह रही है। नीतीश कुमार जी ने एक चुनौती दिया है नरेंद्र मोदी जी को कि आइए जंगल राज पे डिबेट करते हैं। क्या पार्टी इस चीज के लिए तैयार है कि जंगल राज पे एक डिबेट हो? मे बी शायद वो कोई एक नया पॉइंट हो जो कि दिखे कि हाँ बिहार में कुछ नए तरीके की पॉलिटिक्स हो रही है।
देखिए, जंगल राज शब्द का इस्तेमाल भारतीय जनता पार्टी ने नहीं किया, प्रारंभ नहीं किया। इस शब्द का इस्तेमाल पटना हाईकोर्ट ने किया था। उस लालू जी के राज को उन्होंने जंगल राज हाईकोर्ट ने कहा था। नीतीश जी बार बार कहते हैं कि हमने जंगल राज कभी नहीं कहा, हमने आतंक राज कहा। लालू जी को स्पष्ट या नीतीश जी को स्पष्ट करना चाहिए कि जंगल राज आतंक राज में क्या अंतर वो समझते हैं, कौन सा परिवर्तन को दिखाई पड़ता है।
कहा जा रहा है ये पूरा चुनाव इज अ डायरेक्ट कॉन्टेस्ट बिटवीन नीतीश कुमार एंड प्राइम मिनिस्टर नरेंद्र मोदी। लोग क्यों वोट दें, मोदी जी को देखकर या विकास को देखकर कि बिहार में विकास?
नरेंद्र मोदी जी और विकास एक दूसरे के पर्याय हैं, आप दोनों को अलग अलग नहीं कर सकते।
एंड इन द जमुई कंस्टिट्यूएंसी ऑफ बिहार विल बी फॉट वन ऑफ द की इलेक्टोरल बैटल्स ऑफ द स्टेट। On test will be the reputation of former JDU Minister Narendra Singh, who has now defected to the NDA along with his two sons. But ironically, it is the greatest challenge is not from the Grand Alliance, but also from his own NDA partner, the LJP.
Chirag Paswan is the Lok Sabha MP from Jamui. One compelling reason why his party, the LJP, wanted to contest both Jamui and Chakai assembly seats that fall in this constituency. The BJP, however, wanted to give both seats to the sons of former Minister Narendra Singh as a reward for defecting from the JDU along with Jitan Ram Manji. After a running battle within the NDA, the LJP managed to snatch Chakai seat, while the NDA allowed Narendra Singh's son Ajay Pratap to contest the Jamui seat.
हमेशा से विकास ही रहा है, विकास ही रहेगा, सबका साथ सबका विकास।
प्रतिद्वंदी किसको मानते हैं?
प्रतिद्वंदी कोई नहीं है।
From Chakai, the Grand Alliance is fielding Vijay Prakash, the younger brother of Jay Prakash Narayan Yadav. The RJD MP from Banka is planning to put up a good fight.
3 मई से लगातार हम जो है पंचायतबाज घूम रहे हैं। जिस जिस पंचायत में जाते हैं हम पूछते हैं कि कौन कौन सा काम हुआ है, एक भी काम कहीं नहीं हुआ।
Since the feud between Ramvilas Paswan and Narendra Singh runs deep, when the Chakai seat went to the LJP, Narendra Singh's son and sitting MLA Sumit Kumar Singh lost no time in quitting the NDA and contesting as an independent against the LJP's Vijay Singh.
टिकट तो दिया लेकिन वो दे रहे थे अमरपुर से जो उम्मीदवार को मंजूर नहीं था क्योंकि वहाँ उसके लिए नया होता उसने रिफ्यूज किया।
Not willing to forgive the slight, the LJP pulled off the same stunt in Jamui. Its Bihar Pradesh General Secretary is contesting as an independent against Ajay Pratap.
Chakai mein hamare Pradesh ke yuva adhyaksh ko jab NDA ne ticket diya Vijay Kumar Singh ji ko, to wahan par Sumit Kumar Singh ko nirdalay mein ladaya gaya. Isliye main Pradesh Mahasachiv hote hue bhi main Jamui mein nirdalay se namankan kiya hu aaj.
As if this wasn't enough, the BJP's own Panchayati Raj functionary, Vikas Singh, has also thrown in his hat in the ring as an independent in Jamui.
के बीच में कार्यकर्ताओं के बीच में हम जाएंगे कि हम समर्पित भारतीय जनता पार्टी के कार्यकर्ता हैं, बागी उम्मीदवार नहीं हूं, असली उम्मीदवार हूं।
Watching the NDA self-destruct is the Grand Alliance. Narendra Singh isn't just facing a tough battle from the LJP, his own caste men are plotting his defeat. Besides Ajay Pratap, four other Rajput candidates are in the fray. Come verdict day on November 8th, the state will know who has won this dizzying political battle. Bureau Report, Rajya Sabha TV.
Well, that's all in this edition of Verdict 2015. Do watch our election special at 1 p.m. as well. But that is it from me and my election team at the moment. Thanks so much for watching.